This is Carl at National RV Detroit, and I'm going to walk you through this 2022 Salem Hemisphere model number 270 FKS. So this is a how-to video. I'm just going to show you some of the features and how they work. It's not a floor plan video. It's more of a how-to. So, okay, here we go. So this, we're at the door side rear here. So we have some storage back here. Obviously, you have a power stabilizers. One switch controls both rear jacks. The other switch up front controls both front. You have your dump hose with it, of course. And then you have your crank here. That's a 3/4 inch crank. And then this crank right here, the smaller one, is for your power tongue jack up front. I'll show you, there's a plug on the top of it, a rubber plug that you could pull out and crank that manually in an emergency if you need to get hitched or unhitched, just in case something goes wrong with it. All right, so let me just walk over here real quick to look at something. Okay. Yeah, so these stabilizers, I don't know if you can see that, but they can be cranked manually in an emergency, and you would do it from the off-door side. It's like a shaft with a pin through it, and that's where you crank it. Also, if you notice these holes here, there's another one up here. These are, at this point, if you go look through here, you can't really see it, but if you look through all the way to the frame, there's a shaft sticking out with a 3/4 inch hex on it. Well, you can use the 3/4 inch crank, and you can actually crank the slide rooms in and out manually in an emergency. So you can even get them in if something was to happen. You can get them in that way. So that's another good feature. Okay, so you have a power awning with an LED strip, of course. Two doors. Oh, he's locking from the inside. Yes. Two doors. This is the main entry here. We'll go on to the other side in a second. Yeah, outside speakers, like I stated, you have a TV bracket to hang a TV. You got cable or signal out and power right here. This is your water heater. Okay. So let me set that aside. So the thing to know about this water heater, the switches to control it are inside, except right here there's a rocker switch on and off. This rocker switch controls the heating element that's behind this cover here. That works on 110 or 120 AC. So you want to turn that on, you got to flip this switch here. Keep that in mind. There's also a switch for the gas that's inside. When you want to drain it, you use this plug right here. It takes inch and a 16th 6-point socket with about a 6-inch extension and a ratchet or a breaker to break it free, but that's where you drain it at right there. If you drain it and you're putting it into storage, always make sure that you refill the water tank, the hot water tank, before you turn on the heating element or the burner. You don't want to run it dry, so that's important. I'll show you the rest of the switches when we get inside. Never work on this when it's hot. Always let it cool down first, and remember that this is under pressure. So you got to let the pressure out of the hot water lines and tank before you unscrew this. Otherwise, it'll shoot out of there like a cannonball, followed by about a gallon of water. So you don't want to do that. So make sure the pressure is released. And like I said, never do that when it's hot. You don't want to get scalded or worse. Okay. All right. Okay then. This is the vent for the range hood. If you can see, there's a baffle right here. You want that baffle to be flapping freely when you're venting to the outside. You can push it on it and snap it shut for traveling or storage, but if you're venting with it, with the fan, you want that to flap freely. There's your front switches for the front stabilizers. You've got a small AC refrigerator. This is your griddle here. Now keep in mind you need this hose. It's a quick connect hose. You can see this end right here goes on to here, and then underneath the trailer right here, let's see if I can get a good picture of it right there, that's the connect to get you into the LP system of the trailer. So the other end of that rubber LP hose will click right into that quick connect right there. So you have to do that obviously before you use the griddle. Okay, so this is a spray port somewhere in the trailer. We'll see it when we get to it, but there's a coiled sprayer with a coiled hose with a sprayer on the end that you can use to hose things down, kids and dogs and feet or bicycles or whatever you have. Okay, so you have two batteries on this, which is excellent, and they're wired together at 12 volts, so you're just doubling the storage capacity. This is your power tongue jack I told you about. You can pull this plug right here, and that's where you use that small crank to crank it in an emergency. You got two LP tanks that are full with an automatic changeover regulator. Let's see if this is open here. Just a small storage area. And this is your solar controller right here. So right here, this red switch, that is your kill switch for your battery. So let me get my flashlight here. So if you want to shut off the battery, you can do it there. This is your for your solar panel right here. So it's rotating through the system. So right now it's, let me see if I can get it to just stop here so we can see what we're doing. It's going to be hard for me to show you on the, I just lost my flashlight power there. Okay, so we're getting right now, let me see if I can read this fast enough. I'm having a hard time seeing it. 13.8 volts from the battery, which is perfect. You're gaining 6.9 amps from the solar panels that are being stored in the batteries. Now, if this ever goes to 0, 0, and it sometimes it'll flash FUL, it's telling you that there's no more storage in the battery, so the solar panel is not sending anything to the battery because it's full. As soon as you drain the battery down somewhat, it'll start showing what you're gaining. It also shows you amp hours on here, so it tells you everything you need. The most important thing is what you're gaining from the sun. It's going to go anywhere from 0, 0.2 up to 7.8, you know, whatever. Depends on the position of the sun, the position of the trailer, the time of day, all that. So, but that's how you tell right there. We'll get that cleaned off for you. Our guy apparently didn't see it there. Oh, and there's also a switch here for power. I didn't see that, so I didn't need my flashlight. So, okay, so that's the solar controller. This is a Go power system. So you're going to have some literature inside the trailer. You can also go to their website, and they've got tons of information on their website if you want to, if there's anything else you need to learn about it. Okay? All right, so moving towards the back. Please excuse my camera work. I know I'm all over the place. Here are your dump valves. You have a black tank flush, and then you also have your gray tank flush here. Always dump the black first. Black is toilet water waste. Then dump the gray because it's cleaner water than the black. It's sink and shower water. Okay, so to hook up your city water, you're going to just screw the hose right onto here. That's the easiest way and the most common way to get water to the trailer. Now, if you're camping someplace that doesn't have plumbing on the campsite, you can hook the hose up to here and actually fill your fresh water tank right there and then use the outboard pump to pump it. That's if you don't have plumbing in the campsite. You know, some of the state parks, for example, still don't have plumbing. They have a fill station, a big tank when you first come in, and you would fill your fresh water tank there and then use the onboard pump to pump the water. But most places have city water, and this is where you would hook the hose. Now, this one right here is the black tank flush. After you dumped your black tank, if you leave the valve open, you got to read the sticker here, and it'll point out you have to have the black tank valve open. You would hook up the hose to the dump station here, turn it on. It'll spray out your black tank, flush it really well, and it'll also clean off your sensors so you get a good, accurate reading on your monitor panel. So if you've got a working hose at the dump station, something that hasn't been run over or anything like that, it's a good idea to use this every chance you get, okay? This is just a shower here, another shower. Cable and satellite through right here. This is a 50 amp system, right? So you got a 50 amp 30 foot cord. As you can see, we also give you a reducer. We give you two reducers. We give you this one here that reduces it from 50 to 30, and then we give you another one where you can reduce it to 20. just in case you need to plug it in at home to light it up when you're packing or something like that. You know, you can't run the air conditioners off of 20 amp, obviously, but everything else you can. That's just more storage. Okay, so let me move on here. Please bear with me. This housing here tells us it's pre-wired for a backup camera. So if you want to get a Furion backup camera, get the one that fits in that housing, and you'll be able to see when you're backing up. Plus, you'll be able to see what's behind you when you're driving down the road if you choose. This is a pre-prepped, I guess you would call it, or prep for a Lippert telescoping ladder, which is something you'd have to buy, but I guess they entice you into buying it by putting on their hookup there. It's just a ladder that it telescopes, so it goes down into like a foot square area, something like that. And you can stretch it all out, hook it on there, and you can get on the roof with not much trouble. It's a good thing to do because you want to inspect your roof every 90 days according to the manufacturer. So every 90 days you need to go up there, have somebody go up there, look around, check out the sealant, make sure there's no cracking or separation where water can get in, look at the roofing material and the roofing attachments, make sure they weren't damaged by low branches or road debris flying up there or anything like that. You're just protecting your investment. If you don't go up there and look, you don't know what's happening up there. So part of your regular maintenance is inspecting your roof, okay? That's important. All right, so let's go inside. Okay, here we go. Nice and light and bright in here. Okay, so this is your control panel. We'll see what we have here. Awning and two slide outs, right? Never leave your power awning out unattended if you're going to leave the campground, roll it in, of course. Your lights are here. Your water pump's here. Remember I told you the water pump is for pumping out of the fresh water tank when you don't have city water. It's also used to winterize the trailer. To light your water heater on gas is right here. You can see there's your fault light right there. I showed you how to light the or turn on the electricity in the lower left-hand corner there. This also has tank heaters. It has heating pads on all the tanks, plus in the elbow valve area, it'll have it also. So you can extend your camping season by quite a bit because it keeps your tanks from freezing. And then you have all your levels here. So fresh water, it's got a third in it right now because we're prepping. Battery's charged all the way. Black tank is empty. You only have one black tank, so you don't pay attention to the other one. And you're going to have two gray tanks, not three. So they use a standard panel. So one is your one gray tank, and then two will be your galley tank, they call it, which is your kitchen sink water. So keep that in mind. And there is no third on it, I'm sure. I didn't prep this, but I'm sure there's not. Okay, your refrigerator, just so you know, is a 12-volt DC refrigerator. So it runs off 12-volt DC. That means it'll run off the battery. When you're pulling it down the road, for example, your tow vehicle's alternator will charge the batteries, and your batteries will run the refrigerator. When you're, let's see here. When you're plugged into the campground, this is your power converter. So this is your circuit breakers, your sort of your control center here, distribution center. You have circuit breakers like you see at home. They work on AC power, and they're all labeled, of course. Then the power is converted to 12-volt DC over here. So you got 12-volt fuses there, and they're all labeled. Now, if any of these fuses blow, they'll actually light up. You can see them through this tinted plastic here. Let me get that off of there. And an important feature of this is a battery tender. So when you're plugged into campground power, it'll sense how much energy your batteries need, and it'll always keep them charged. It'll send a couple amps up there to maintain it if they're charged, or it can send 10 or 15 or whatever, however many amps it needs to charge it. So when you're pulling it down the road, like I stated, your tow vehicle's alternator charges them. When you're plugged in, this power converter charges it. Okay. I'm sure you may know all this stuff buying a nice trailer like this, but I still have to go over it because some people don't know it. This is your carbon dioxide LP gas detector. This one is for carbon dioxide. This light here is for LP. It should always be green like it is. If not, get it serviced. If it goes off, obviously you take everybody outside. It's detected carbon monoxide or LP buildup. And so leave the door open, take everybody outside, shut the gas off of the front and figure out what's going on, okay? Keep that in mind. Never ignore it, obviously. Not that you can, it's loud. And it's hardwired to the battery also. So therefore, it will drain the battery down. You do have the panel on here, so it probably won't. But that's why one of the reasons they give you a kill switch for the battery up front, in case when you put it in storage, you just want to shut everything down, okay? Alrighty. Keys. This is your other adapter from 30 to 20, okay? This is your microwave. Works like any other microwave. This is your range hood. Remember I told you about the baffle on the outside. If you're going to run the fan, you want that baffle open so it vents to the outside. You got a light there. I don't know if you got the gas turned on here. If not, I'll just talk you through it. Otherwise, Alexa would light it. This is the sparker. You turn this clockwise to spark the burners in the oven. You have three knobs and three burners, and then this one's for the oven. So let me see. I hear it. Maybe I don't. I think gas is coming out. He's just hooked up the tanks, for example. There it goes. So once you get all the air out of the line, replaced with gas, as soon as you turn it, it'll light. But there you go. It was just purging the air out. So when it comes to the oven, there's a, all the way on the bottom at the back, there's a pilot light. Maybe I can spark it for you so you can see it. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. Which type of oven is this? Okay, so what you're gonna do is you go to the oven knob, you go to the picture of the flame, and you depress it. You keep it depressed during the whole lighting procedure. You spark it till the pilot light down here lights. After it lights, you're still holding this in. You hold it for another 10 seconds or so to heat up the thermocouple. Then you go to operating temperature. When you shut it off, the flame goes out, obviously, but so does the pilot light. So you have to relight the pilot light each time you use the oven. Always travel with this closed, the top down like this. Okay. Strap your chairs down so that it doesn't keep them from moving, but it keeps them from flying around. You don't want it to hit a wild bump and then bounce it through the window or something like that. Okay. Theater seats, your TV obviously, and you have a sound bar here. So let's see, this would be the controller for your sound bar, and this one is for your TV here, and then this other one here is for the, hold on a second please, it's for the fireplace below it. So let me just do this. Okay, so with your Furion soundbar, you get FM radio, no AM, just FM. Let me find some light in here, I'm sorry. There we go, maybe that'll help. Okay. All right, so you have FM radio. It has Bluetooth, so you can stream wirelessly from your phone or your tablet. You can stream off a USB drive right here. Just put all your favorite albums or all your albums onto one stick and take them with you. This HDMI is an in. So if you need to go into the system with, let's say, a portable Blu-ray player or something, you can go right in there. You just select the proper mode. It has two speaker zones, one and two. One is inside the trailer, two is the outside speakers. So it does all of that. I'm looking. The TV has to be strapped. It's strapped right now, so keep that in mind when you're traveling. Also, I can't quite see it back here, but it's telling us that it's pre-wired for a King Connect is the company. It's pre-wired for a Wi-Fi digital signal booster, right? So keep that in mind. It consists of an antenna on the roof and a router. If you're ever interested, you can get the web address off this plate there and look into it. You also want to make sure that, I don't know if you can see this, but it's glowing green right now. If I shut this off, it turns off. But right there is green. This is the digital booster for your digital antenna, so you always want it green like that or you will not get a good picture. Alright, down here there's your fireplace. So 00 is the fan speed. Oh, let me see if I can get a good, better thing here. Low is the fan speed. High, right, and back to 00, which is off. So you got three span speeds. It's a really good space heater. Then you can change the pitch, the crystal colors. You can change the flame colors. As I look through for my favorite one here. Okay, so you can do all that. Plus, it has a timer on it, so you can set it to turn on or turn off when you choose. Okay, it's a really good space heater. So when those days you don't need to use up your limited supply of LP gas, you can just run the fireplace heater and save your LP for another day. Okay, so this is now de-winterized. So I'm going to take this one sticker off, because it's in summarized right now. All right, to draw the antifreeze into your system and do all that sort of thing is done behind this panel. Two number two square headed screws holding it in, so keep that in mind. Shower works like any other shower, sink like any other sink. You have a fan, of course. And when it comes to your toilet, you have to remember that it works like every other RV toilet. There's a flush pedal here, and the black tank is directly below, right? So you can't use it dry. So after you plug in your trailer, turn on your hook up your water and your power, you'll come in here, you'll put a dose of chemical in the bowl, and then step on the pedal and let a gallon or so of water go into the black tank along with the chemical. Then you're set to use it. You can't use it dry because the smell will be terrible, plus it can get clogged up. So you always have to have chemical and water in it before you start using it. Never use it with a dry black tank. Okay. All right, so let's see what we got here. This is just wardrobe. This one here looks like it's just the extension on the wardrobe. Here we go. And let me look at this one here. Yeah, so this is pre-plumbed and wired for a washer-dryer stackable combo. So you already have the plumbing there and the hookups. You just have to add the vent. So if you ever want to add a washer dryer stack in here, you can do it right there. Okay, let me get this on there. There we go. Okay, so you can hang another TV here. There's a backer plate here. That's what they're telling you. You've got your signal and your power there, so that's simple. There's storage underneath the bed, so if you ever have to you can always lift it up, I guess I should just show you, and it sort of meets up with what's outside. Okay. Alrighty, let me look around a little bit more, see if I forgot anything. I think I've covered most of it. Yeah, I believe so. So, okay. So I want to thank you for purchasing your trailer here at National RV Detroit. Please remember what I said about inspecting your roof every 90 days. That's important. It's just part of the maintenance schedule of owning a trailer. Right now, we talked about this trailer is not winterized anymore. All the antifreeze has been purged from it. It's been replaced with fresh water. I just want to look in here, make sure I'm not forgetting anything for you. And it's placed with fresh water. Your water heater valves are in camping mode, and the water heater has water in it, so you're all set, ready to go. Okay? Thank you very much.